Today I'd like to take a few minutes and visit with you about the horse's large intestine or the hind gut. In recent years, more and more interest and research has been given to the function of the horse's hind gut. This is a very dynamic and a very important part of the horse's digestive system. The horse is actually a hind gut fermenter. This means that he relies on fermentation, which takes place in his hind gut or his large intestine, in order to assimilate nutrients. In fact, it is so important to the horse, we often refer to the horse as being a fermentation vat on four legs with an attitude. And in many cases, that's very true, because without proper fermentation in the large intestine, the horse will suffer from many different and various health disorders. When the horse's hindgut does not function properly, this can lead to many different anomalies that I'm sure at one point in time or another you've noticed or experienced with one of your horses. They'll suffer from a reduced appetite, and this goes hand in hand with the large intestine. If we have good, active, normal fermentation in the large intestine, the horse will have a good appetite in most cases. If we don't have good fermentation in the large intestine, the horse's appetite is often the first thing that goes down. It's often the first thing that we notice that lets us know that fermentation is not correct or not proper and balanced the way we want it to be. Without proper fermentation, the horse cannot assimilate nutrients correctly or efficiently. As a result, we get other things that happen with the horse, such as the hair coat becomes dull, can become rough. We can have poor hoof quality because we can't get those nutrients to the foot. And we can also get a general change in the horse's attitude. We, here at Equivision, we oftentimes get asked to examine a horse because the owner or the trainer has noticed an attitude change. And many times that attitude change has been a direct result of what's gone wrong or changes that have taken place in that horse's large intestine. In more serious cases, when fermentation or the health of the hindgut goes down, this can result in problems such as diarrhea, colic, or even colitis, which can actually be a fatal situation. So the health of the large intestine or the hindgut is extremely important for the horse. Now, veterinarians, nutritionists, horsemen often use terms such as hindgut, large intestine, colon. We use these terms interchangeably. We're all talking about the same thing. Okay, the large intestine is actually made up of three parts: the cecum, the large colon, and the small colon. Combined, these three components make up about 25 gallons of material in your horse's large, that is the large intestine, which holds about 25 gallons. So you can see this is a very large area which contains an awful lot of water. So anytime things get dry, anytime things go wrong, that's a large area to cause your horse a lot of discomfort. Now, in that 25-gallon fermentation vat, you actually have billions of different bacteria and protozoa, different microbes that actually do the fermenting. They have to be there for your horse's large intestine to work correctly. The composition of those bacteria are going to be determined by the horse's diet and the horse's environment. The horse is constantly being challenged with bacteria that we don't want there, such as Salmonella or E. coli. So we want your horse's defense system to have a means to keep those Salmonella and E. coli that are everywhere in the environment down at as low level as possible. By the same token, we want good bacteria that are going to do a good job of fermenting food for the horse to be at a high level as possible. And as we just mentioned, the diet has a major effect on that. Those microbes in the large intestine are also your horse's first defense mechanism to disease. Immunity starts in the horse's gut, and the proper microbial population and the right number of microbes in that large intestine are required for your horse's immune system to function correctly. Unfortunately, 60 to 70% of all performance horses will suffer from problems with their hind gut at some point in time in their career. So when you walk through a barn and you might have 10 horses in that barn or 10 horses in that shed row, that means approximately 6 of those horses are going to have hindgut problems. So this is a very common situation, but it's one that if caught early is easily corrected. Now at Equivision, we score hindgut health in one of four ways. We say the horse's hindgut or large intestine is either normal. Number two, it's either static or is in a, what we call it, stasis. This is a situation where the horse isn't really sick, but the hindgut just isn't working the way it should be. Number three would be hindgut inflammation. This is actually a fairly common situation that we find in high performance horses that are under a lot of stress. The fourth one would be what we refer to as hindgut ulceration, more commonly referred to as colitis. That is a very serious situation. So what we want to do now is discuss these four classifications, so hopefully you can pick up when your horse is at, you know, just at a static or stasis level. Certainly we want you to be able to pick up when your horse has got inflammation in the hindgut before that problem goes all the way and progresses to ulceration or colitis, because that can be a life-threatening situation. Unlike gastric ulcers, there's really no definitive way that we can diagnose hindgut inflammation. As you know, with gastric ulcers, a veterinarian can scope the stomach and actually see the ulcers in the stomach. We cannot scope the large intestine. As a result, we have to use powers of observation. We have to use our familiarity, or the rider or the trainer's familiarity with that horse. Combine that with some lab results. But it's primarily just looking for certain signs of intestinal discomfort, inflammation, and how that horse might change over time based on the owner's familiarity with that horse. So how do we know if your horse's large intestine is normal? A horse's large intestine is normal when that horse has got a normal appetite, his hair coat quality is good, his hoof quality is good, he's maintaining his weight fine. And a note on weight maintenance. Obviously, if a horse is very skinny, that's an indication that his digestive tract may not be working correctly. But likewise, a horse that's obese, we normally think, oh, he's an easy keeper, he lives on air, he doesn't have any problem digesting his food. That's a true statement, but now we are finding out that how that horse digests his food can also affect horses that are too fat. So there are means now, by changing the fermentation in that hindgut, we can help some of these easy keepers actually lose some of that extra adipose tissue and lose some of that fat and increase their insulin sensitivity. So a horse that's got a normal fermentation vat, he's healthy, he's got energy, he's got stamina, he's normal by definition. Now a horse that's got a static large intestine, this essentially means that the microbe or the microbial population in the hindgut is not what it needs to be. Either the number of bacteria that exist in the hindgut is not great enough to keep fermentation going strong. One of the reasons for that is dehydration, which with a high performance horse can be a problem. Or it could mean that the actual makeup of that population is not what it needs to be. So we've got bacteria, we've got fermentation, but we don't have the right bacteria in that hindgut. Horses that have a static gut usually are horses that show a reduction in their appetite. They'll still eat, they'll still clean up their diet, but they just don't go at it with a lot of vigor. They're just kind of dull. And as a result, their attitude tends to be a little bit dull. In many cases with performance horses, they may still be compliant, they may still do everything you ask them to do, but they just don't do it with a lot of energy, they don't do it with a lot of, okay, let's go. They may still give you all they've got, but you may notice as a rider, they don't give you as much as they used to. Also, horses with a static gut are going to be more susceptible to excessive gas production and or impactions. So you may or may not see an increase in the incidence of colics when the horse is just static. Now, with a static gut, this is actually easy to fix. All we really have to do in this situation is possibly make a minor dietary change so that we get more fermentable food back into that hind gut, and we can utilize things like probiotics and prebiotics to help reestablish a good, healthy, active microbial population to get fermentation going again. The next classification is intestinal inflammation. We actually see quite a few high-performance horses that have intestinal inflammation. These horses will have all the same symptoms of those horses that have a static gut, but they'll show more discomfort. The mucosa of the intestine might begin to be thickened a little bit. There might be some mild ulceration when a horse has inflammation. These horses will almost always show a change in attitude. Sometimes a comment from riders and trainers is they become cinchy. In other words, when you tighten up the cinch on the saddle, they react in ways that they didn't used to. I have personally examined horses that obviously had intestinal inflammation, and when I've put my hand on the flank area, I've gotten a foot coming towards my face. They don't want to be touched there. They're very uncomfortable. Along with this, they'll show tightness over the back area, the loin area. They'll show tightness down the hamstrings. This is a result of them standing there trying to relieve that discomfort in that flank and hindgut area. They may be, what we say, cut up in the flank, have that greyhound look to the flank area, much more so than they should given their activity level. They may actually be tight in the abdominal muscles. So it is a very uncomfortable condition for them, and as a result, they react that way. They have a negative change in attitude. When you're riding the horse may be reluctant to change leads. He may be reluctant to change a particular lead. You might find that he's very sensitive to your right leg, but not your left leg. Horses will tell you in very subtle ways, and this is why I mentioned familiarity with the horse helps you identify and diagnose what the problem is. The fourth classification would be ulceration. And this would be a very serious medical condition which does require a veterinarian's intervention. Now, horses with ulceration or colitis almost always are going to have some degree of diarrhea. They're going to have a loss in weight. There'll be changes in blood chemistry such as low blood protein, low white blood cell counts. If you suspect that your horse is that severe, it would be or is very important that your horse receive veterinary care. Your veterinarian can help reestablish or help heal those ulcers, help reestablish good fermentation in that hind gut. And once you get to that point, then either the veterinarian can recommend dietary changes or the veterinarian working along with a qualified nutritionist can change your horse's diet and make some recommendations to help get your horse back to being healthy and get them back to being normal. So, as we discussed, the horse's large intestine is a major component of his overall digestive system. How it functions determines your horse's immunity function, his level of immunity. It determines how he's going to utilize food. It can determine his attitude. It can determine his willingness to perform. It's going to determine his ability to perform in terms of his energy level and his stamina. Now, Equivision has developed a 21-day hindgut health program, which if you feel that your horse has a hindgut problem, our 21-day hindgut health program can very quickly help your horse heal inflammation and reestablish good fermentation to get him back to optimal performance.